So I'm KB with Nerdophiles. How are you?
Hi, KB. Great.
High on the Hog, honestly, is unlike anything I've ever seen. And it's really quite hard to put into words kind of the magnitude of learning and unlearning and shared experiences and nuances and so much more that comes with this. So talk a little bit about the fullness of the experience of being able to go back to the continent and to bring the ancestors home, but also, really be able to bond and experience the people while also getting such a rich history lesson on the foods that have sustained us for decades and decades.
Yeah, wow. I'm sorry, can you ask the question one more time?
Yeah, no problem. Can you
Trying
just
to make
share
sure.
a little bit more about kind of the fullness of the experience you
Yeah.
had on the continent and just, being able to get that rich history of the foods and also experiencing the people and so much more?
Yeah, got you. I think that the first episode when we're in Africa, is really a perfect way to immerse the show, not just because that's how the book begins, but because the story itself is a chronological story. It's a story that is largely about, African American people, our arrival, how we got there and how we came to be. And beginning in Africa, just for those African Americans who have never had the experience, the pleasure and privilege of being on the continent, seeing your likeness reflected back to you, your physical likeness, your physical features, characteristics, the ways that we move, talk, dance, even though this is not something that, of course, we know when convening and speaking to each other. It's something that when you're in Africa feels part of a ancestral connection and continuum. And for me, that was the most prevalent feeling in Africa. And then, of course, having a culinary and icon, luminary like Dr. Jessica B. Harris by my side in that experience was just really beyond. I'm still struggling to articulate what that was like. And so I think, for me, just the familiarity of being on the continent and seeing our people there was so powerful, and I hope that people are moved to explore that food history and the adjacent history that goes along with it.
Yeah, you mentioned kind of having these iconic figures throughout the show, and obviously Dr. Harris is, the author of the book, but there's so many also additional incredible chefs and people that you connect it to with, that you connect with and then connect to each other, I feel like, kind of on this journey. So can you talk a little bit about, how these partnerships came to life for this particular docuseries? Because I admittedly, I'm from Houston and you introduced me to a couple of people in the food scene that I have yet to know until I watch this. So.
Brilliant. I'm glad to hear that. I think the show, the brilliance of the show, and this can be this is a credit to, the executive producers, Fabian Tobeck and Karis Jagger, was really about enlivening this text, this very formative text with the faces of today's kind of Black culinary food renaissance, which is happening in the US and globally. And so, being around people like BJ Dennis, Michael Twitty in South Carolina, Gabrielle Etienne in North Carolina, Omar Tate in Philadelphia. In many ways, this is kind of the culinary vanguard for Black folks in the US. And I think you'll see in their talent is just so clear and apparent on screen. So I'm excited for the world to get to meet them.
I am too, that I could ask you 100 more questions because I know you mentioned you're from Georgia. That's where I went to college. So I feel like this was a
Okay.
perfect kind of blend of my life coming together, even when you went to New York and how many years I spent living there. So I just cannot wait for everyone to see it because there is such an authentic connection that happens amongst everyone that's involved with you kind of at the helm. And the food looked fantastic 98% of the time. I was like, y'all bring this to my house. So just thank you for this body of work, and I cannot wait for everyone to see it. And thank you so much.